I will not be writing the complete journal entry, but I will be giving you the classification. You can attempt to write the journal entry in the format that we have discussed earlier. So I will not give you the complete journal entry, rather I will simply give you the type of account. You decide whether they are to be debited or credited and attempt it like an exercise. And if at all any transaction is difficult in this, for that I will be giving you the solution. So last problem, that is problem number 8. The first transaction is started business with a capital of 90,000. So the accounts affected here are, we say capital and cash. So naturally, capital being the amount given by the owner, it is a personal account. So you decide whether the owner is the giver or receiver and debit or credited. I will not be telling. Cash is a real account. So you decide whether it should be debited or credited and write the journal entry in the format. Now the second transaction is on the same date, purchased goods on credit from Tarun. Purchased goods from Tarun on credit. So purchase of goods means we will take the accounts as purchases as one, which is representing goods. So being goods, it becomes real account. You decide whether the goods are coming in or going out when you purchase and apply the rule. Next is Tarun. Tarun is which account? Personal account. So whether Tarun in this case is the giver of the goods or receiver of the goods, decide and apply the rule of debit and credit to Tarun and write the journal entry. Next is on second, it is sold goods to Sonu. Sold goods to Sonu. So here again we have goods, which is real account. So we will refer with the word sales because we are selling the goods. Again, goods being real account. So apply the rule of debit if goods are coming in this case, and apply the rule of credit if they are going out. So to whom did we sell? We sold the goods to Sonu. So being a credit transaction, we take Sonu, and Sonu is a person, therefore personal account. So you decide whether you will debit Sonu or credit Sonu. Now the next transaction is goods returned to Ragan. On third, we have purchased goods from Ragan for cash. Purchased goods from Ragan for cash. So on third, it is purchase of goods from Ragan for cash. Therefore, we have purchases account, which is representing goods, which is a real account. So you decide whether goods are coming here or going out and apply the rule of real account. Then we have purchased the goods for cash. So cash is again real account. So apply the rule of real account for cash. If it is coming in, debited. If it is going out, credited. Now the next transaction is on fourth. It is like sold goods to Tony for cash. Sold goods to Tony for cash. So on fourth, you have sales. So sales means again, it is goods, which is real account. So check when you sell goods, they're going out or coming in, and apply the rule. So again, it is stated, we sold it for cash. Cash again is a real account. Think cash is coming in or going out and apply the rule. Now, next transaction says that goods returned to Ragan. Goods returned to Ragan. So what are goods either we buy or sell? So returned to Ragan means we are not Ragan. So therefore we are Sudhan company in this case. So Sudhan company is returning the goods to Ragan. So it would have been definitely the goods purchased on credit from Ragan previously. We may not know in these transactions somewhere there is no name of Ragan, but we do have Ragan's name in third date, which states that we purchased goods from Ragan for cash. So don't mistake that we are returning these goods, because whenever we purchase goods for cash from anyone, we don't have the right, means we cannot return them back. Only when we buy goods on credit, there is a provision for us to return such goods. So on fifth, so we can't say that, you know, that this is related to the transaction on third. Rather, it could have been related to somewhere in June, May, etc. of the previous months when we would have purchased these goods from Ragan on credit. Now, so when we are returning the goods to Ragan, it becomes purchase returns. So purchases returns. So goods, and it is being a real account. Now you are returning the goods which you have purchased previously. Think whether they are going out or coming in now, and give the debit or credit according to the real account. Then to whom we are returning the goods? Ragan. So Ragan is a person, so therefore personal account. Decide when you return goods to Ragan, Ragan will receive the goods or he will give the goods and apply the rule.